Okay. So what I was actually telling you about the machine learning is that, I mean, other than machine learning, you have to learn the technologies. So we'll learn a lot of technologies which are associated with the analytics, okay? Now we have got two projects. One is the create analytics report for Sunbird LMS. So for that purpose, we'll be using the Sunbird data APIs and the Sunbird telemetry service. Okay. And the second is the enhancement of the open edX analytics. I think my previous one, Rapurna, has already talked to you about the open edX platform, but it has got an analytics platform which is separate than the open edX platform. The one which she talked about is the LMS and CMS, that is a learning management system and content management system. So that is a separate site, and analytics is a separate site. So you have to go from the instructor dashboard to the analytics site. Okay, so we are talking about the enhancement of that analytics site. Okay. So this is the whole purpose, is to measure the effectiveness of FDPs of a faculty development program which is conducted by IIT Bombay X. So in the faculty development program, they have introduced some few measures to find out how effective is the course is. So our whole idea is to give them the metrics of that. That is, whatever they have introduced, the new features, we have to give the metrics of those features. Now first we'll talk about the create analytics reports for Sunbird LMS, that is learning management system. Now that LMS, Sunbird has got these components: organization, users, courses, assessment, forums and services like data API, gateway, telemetry services, etc. Okay. So organization is, if you, they cater to different organizations, so you can have the organization data. So whenever you are doing the analytics, you will be doing the analytics for a particular organization. So you need to use that organization data. Users is for the users, that is if you want to have a particular user or the collective collection of users, you have to use the users database. Then you have the courses, which is the content of the course. Then assessment is actually the quizzes, so which you'll be using to assess how much the learner has learned. And then forums, they have got some discussion forums in which the participation and other things, that is how people are participating, that we can find out. And all these things you can get from the using data API gateway. That is, you have to use data API, you cannot directly access the data, you have to use that API and their authentication service to get the data from the data API. They already have some analytics, which is in two categories. One is a creation analytics, another is a consumption analytics. And for that, you have to specify the duration during which you want to have the analytics figures. So creation analytics is like total number of contents created, total number of authors, total number of reviewers. This is actually the number of things, that number of total content created on the portal, so that kind of things. And then you can download the reports using the CSV format. And the consumption analysis is that how many people, number of users has visited the site, then content consumption, that is how much time they have spent on each content, so average time spent by user per visit. So all these things are already available. You can get it from their dashboard. Now we are, I'll be coming to the talking about the installation types. This is important because we have to know which installation we'll be using for our development purpose. So one is that, first is that you can install it on your machine. This is actually basically a portal installation, and another is a medium scale installation. Now in the first installation, it will install only the front end, and in the second installation, it will install both the front end and the back end. Okay. So, but right now this medium scale deployment is not available, which my earlier speaker Dockers, this he said, so they will be installing using the Dockers. So that it uses the Docker technology, that medium scale deployment. Okay, now we'll be using only developers installation, so which is a portal installation, and front end is a portal, back end is a cloud instance of the Sunbird, which they have installed for the purpose of demonstration and usage of APIs. And you have to configure the Sunbird portal using their API. You have to get an API key from their authentication token, and then you have to use that for installation in the cloud. And the technical components which are used is mostly Node.js, AngularJS and jQuery. AngularJS is used for the portal front end, Node.js is a back end, and jQuery is used by both of them. So you'll be using this one for creating reports. And for creating reports, we'll be using the APIs. They have got four categories of APIs: feature APIs, administration APIs, setup APIs, and data APIs. Second thing which you'll be using is a telemetry service. Telemetry service is actually the logging of the events. So that is most necessary for the analytic purpose. So when they are doing this telemetry, that event capturing, they have got some standard structure where they have who is doing it, what content he is accessing, then where, in which context, all those things come in the whatever results they send, the telemetry data, which you get by sending the request. And in the telemetry request, you have to have the auth token, which you have to take from them. They'll generate the auth token and will give it to you. Then you will have to use a channel ID, that is which content, API key, and they have got the standalone JS library for telemetry. So you have to use that library.